Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Today we celebrate the eighth Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please see the bulletin for the Ash Wednesday Mass schedule and the area penance service schedule. Please see the insert in this week's bulletin for all Lenten activities and prayer opportunities during the Lenten season. Immaculate Conception's fish dinner has been canceled. We will begin Children's Liturgy of the Word next Sunday at the 9:30 Mass at Immaculate Conception. Please note this is the only Mass that we will offer it. In a special way, we remember the soul of Paul Mongeau at this Mass. Our gathering hymn for today's Mass is Alleluia, Sing to Jesus, found in your worship aid.
Spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have really sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have failed to do. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
A reading from the book of Sirach. When a sieve is shaken, the husks appear. So do one's faults when one speaks. As the test of what the potter molds is in the furnace, so in tribulation is the test of the just. The fruit of a tree shows the care it has had. So too does one's speech disclose the bent of one's mind. Praise no one before he speaks, for it is then that people are tested. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, when this which is corruptible clothes itself with incorruptibility, and this which is mortal clothes itself with immortality, then the word that is written shall come about. Death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is in the law. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brothers and sisters, be firm, steadfast, always fully devoted to the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
With
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus told his disciples a parable. Can a blind person guide a blind person? Will not both fall into a pit? No disciple is superior to the teacher. But when fully trained, every disciple will be like his teacher. Why do you notice the splinter in your brother's eye, but do not perceive the wooden beam in your own? How can you say to your brother, "Brother, let me remove that splinter in your eye," when you do not even notice the wooden beam in your own eye? You hypocrite, remove the wooden beam from your eye first, then you will see clearly to remove the splinter in your brother's eye. A good tree does not bear rotten fruit, nor does a rotten tree bear good fruit. For every tree is known by its own fruit, for people do not pick figs from thorn bushes, nor do they gather grapes from brambles. A good person out of the store of goodness in his heart produces good, but an evil person out of a store of evil produces evil. For from the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. The Gospel of the Lord. I've been watching current events in my home country, Philippines. One of the prevailing issues now there is the upcoming national presidential election, which would happen on the second week of May this year. Political campaign strategies like negative campaigning are so obvious, as usual. It is to paint one's opponent bad so that one who does it would appear good. The typical holier than thou attitude. We know that this is not only happening in politics, but this is also present in any public sphere of our lives. Unfortunate though, this is also happening even in our Christian community, in the church. No wonder while Jesus repeatedly called the Pharisees hypocrite on many occasions in the gospel, it is significant that in today's reading, he is saying the very same thing to his own disciples. To the disciples, he said, "You hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take the speck out of your neighbor's eye." What happened, therefore, is that it is easy to paint the wrongdoings or shortcomings of other people instead of seeing our own failures first. This is the holier-than-thou attitude. One considers himself more righteous or moral than other people. based upon his own standards of judgment. When someone does not conform to his, he would start to think of himself as better than that someone who differ from him. However, this is a clear manifestation of hypocrisy. This is what the Greek word hypokritai means. It used to refer to a stage actor who is playing a role in which he is the tragic, misunderstood hero whom the rest of the characters of the drama are out to get him. However, it is usually quite a false and misleading picture of the reality. In the same way that a holier-than-thou attitude is a slippery trap that can easily ensnare. But one thing is certain, hypocrisy will not go long undetected. As the gospel today is saying, no really good tree can produce bad fruit, and no really bad tree can consistently produce genuinely good fruit. And in the first reading, we heard, shake up the sieve, and the rubbish soon appears. So Jesus, in today's gospel, cautioned the people of his time, and of course to us today, about those who would correct the defects of others while failing to detect the monstrous and therefore more evident failures on their part. Jesus exhorts his listeners, especially those who aim to be teachers and leaders, to examine themselves and to make authentic efforts to correct themselves. That is why in last Sunday's gospel, Jesus told us not to judge, or we would be judged ourselves if we fail to see the defects we have in ourselves. But this does not mean, though, that we do not need or never criticize other people. Because to go back to the term criticize, it comes from the Greek word krino or krisis, which means to make a rational judgment. In this sense, what is being forbidden by Jesus is not judgment as such, but negative, destructive judgment. So the truth of the matter is that there are times when we are expected to give constructive and helpful criticism. The only thing is that, as Jesus teaches, it is imperative that we should have a good eyes and heart for gathering information and in making judgments. That we should have a good mouth and hands for speaking good things and in acting on them. To put it simply, we should follow the example of Jesus. The disciple is not above the teacher. This is to say that our judgments should be like with what Jesus did. The one who is fully qualified will be like the teacher. To be like Jesus will do the act of judging in order to save and help, not to knock down or destroy. If we are to avoid blindness, we need to walk in the footsteps of Jesus. Let us remember that in reality, we are naturally good because God Himself is the one who fashioned us. There may be times we are influenced badly by some events around us that distort our person. But as what Saint Paul reminds us in our second reading, be firm, steadfast always, truly devoted to the work of the Lord. It means that we should adhere to the call of self-formation according to the teachings of the Lord. Because if we are firm in our word to the Lord, this will also form our person. And in the process, we can learn to be totally accepting the way other people are. In the same way, that we can take off our actor's mask, our own hypocrisy, and be fully of ourselves, and let other people also be themselves. In that sense, we are no longer worried about planks in our own eyes or in others, because we judge ourselves by the standards of Jesus. Obviously, this would sound a much better recipe than a life spent in never-ending gripping and sniping. Please stand. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God.
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, I believe the Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, born of God for all ages, life, true God from true God, God not made, unfixed with the Father, for whom all things were made.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that the wisdom of God may enlighten our words and actions, so that we may truly live as disciples of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of the Ukraine, as they face invasion and war, that they may be kept safe and a swift, peaceful solution may be found to end the conflict, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all refugees and displaced persons throughout the world, that God will protect them from harm and mistreatment and guide them to places of safety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Christians, especially members of our faith community, that we may grow in faith and holiness as we begin the Lenten season this week, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those on our Catholic community prayer list and all who are sick, addicted, or suffering in any way, that they may trust in God's great love for them and experience peace and healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may enjoy the eternal love and peace of God's kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Listen to the prayers of your children, Lord. Grant us the capacity to forgive from our hearts, so that we may be one with you, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The children's choir will be singing The Greatest Gift.
receive the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who provide gifts to be offered to your name, and count our oblations as signs of our desire to serve you with devotion, we ask of your mercy that what you grant us, the source of merit, may also help us to attain merit's reward through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
And with your hands, O Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, so that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, And giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Larry our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say your words and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Today's communion hymn is I Have Loved You, found in your worship aid. The children's choir will be singing God Be With You.
God be with you. God be with you too.
with which you bring us in the present age, you may make us the takers of life eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
All love and the blessing. The Almighty God always give you, give every adversity far from you, and in his kindness pour out upon you the gifts of his blessing. Amen. May God keep your hearts attentive to his words, that they may be filled with everlasting gladness.
Amen.
And so may you always understand what is good and right, and be found ever listening along in the path of God's commands, made whom is the citizens of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the mighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Let us go in peace.
Today's recessional hymn is Alleluia, Alleluia, found in your worship aid.
Turn.